Myself is Atal Mishra from Kendriya Vidyalaya, and today's topic is the carbon and its compound. That is of the 10th class chapter, and in fact this is the backbone of the chemistry which you will take in the 11th and 12th, that is in the higher classes. Organic chemistry, basically the chemistry of carbon compounds. You will see the separate branch of chemistry in the higher classes. And for carbon, we have a separate chemistry, that is organic chemistry. But today we have to go through the carbon, why it is so important and why we are studying it separately. Let me show you some of the tools which I have in fact created, in fact accrued in my house itself. And I'm sure that it is very much there in your house itself. See, this is the wood, but in fact it is the chandan. That is very important, and you know this is used for the puja purpose, right? Again, I am taking the diya and bati, that is aarti, and again it is very important, you know, during the puja. But I will show later on in the during the class how they are important for us. This is what I have taken. This is a ghee, and in fact you can see. This is very important, and again I say, see, this is the food for your healthy life, right? I am showing another things for you, that is the soap, and we are using it daily. And in the days of corona, every moment you are in fact asked by your television channel, everyone, elder and all, that you should wash your hand continuously after regular interval time for 20 seconds. That is what soap. This is the detergents. These all are the tools for our today's study. And detergents, you know, right? This will come to you. And of course, this is the sanitizer. Sanitizer again, they are the very important tools for today's life. In the age of corona, you can say, corona time, you can say. And that is what I have taken for you. This is the detergent powder. This is the detergent powder. And that was the detergent tikiya. And here I have taken tea leaf for you. I'm not going to prepare tea for you. And if you come and visit to my house, I will serve you. And this is what? Sugar. This is the sugar, you know, chini. And I'm taking another thing, milk. Again, very important. This is the complete diet, a complete food for our diet. And I have taken here for this. This is vinegar, in fact. This is the crude vinegar that is procured from our own field. And in fact, it is fermented from sugar syrup, that is ganna saras, you know it. So all these things are going to become very important for today's study. And I will take all these experimental tool time to time. And why I have shown all these articles, not to make you attract. In fact, you are attracted, that's why you are there. And I'm welcoming you all again. These things, when we analyze, all these things are basically coming from either plant or animal. So anything which we are using, which we are observing, which we are in fact finding in our nature, either from plant or from animal, they must contain carbon. They must contain carbon in their backbone. See, like sugar are basically carbohydrate. The name itself so that they are they are made up of carbon and hydrogen and oxygen. This is protein, and protein basically made up of carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, and hydrogen that we'll analyze in your higher classes. And this is what? This is in fact fat or oil, and this is what? Ghee, you can say. But oil and ghee, everything, this is saturated and unsaturated, that is a different part of the story we will take in the higher classes, again I'm saying. But again, this contain carbon. How can you prove that this oil or ghee contain carbon? And during the course of study, I will show you when I will burn, whether this contain oil or ghee. The burning will create impaired flame and smoke. And when anything is burning with black smoke, you must think that they must contain carbon, because the carbon dioxide, which is produced during the combustion, when mixed with the dust and all, it become dark in appearance, right? So that is how all these things are going to serve purpose of our study today. Screen share. Okay, friend, I am just taking all the material for you so that you can find everything easy. This is what, in fact, I'm showing you. This is the chapter 4, carbon and its compound. Myself is Atul Mishra again. I'm welcoming you all. And in fact, I have shown some of the things here in this picture. You are going to find the wood and coke, diamond, fuels, etc. and etc. So carbon is present in every part of our atmosphere, inside earth crust and all in living organism. Carbon is present in fuels like wood, coal, charcoal, coke, petroleum, and also present in compounds like carbonate, hydrogen carbonate, and hydrogen carbonate is very popularly present inside your ENO, right? And carbonate in the form of carbon dioxide when dissolved in water or any other liquid medium, it becomes carbonate, particularly in water. And you know, friend, that cold drink contains carbonate. And sometimes, since it is acidic in nature, so sometimes people are advising you not to take the cold drink, because if it is older, then there are chances of more amount of acid and they can dissolve your enamel. Carbon is also found in free states such as diamond, graphite and fullerenes. All these things we have discussed. Diamond, graphite and fullerenes, all are the allotropes of the carbon. And most important thing, in fact, I have discussed in last class why the carbon is so important for our study. The most important part of the carbon is the bonding. We have to start the chapter and we have discussed all those things. So I am going through this slide quickly. Bonding in carbon is basically covalent bond. And reason behind is that atomic number of carbon is 6 and electronic configuration, the arrangement of electrons in the carbon atom is 2 and 2, 4. That means the first cell, that is K cell, there are 2 electrons. In the second cell, that is L cell, outer cell, there are 4 electrons. To any element to attain its stability, it must have 8 electrons in outer cell. Here, carbon is lagging 4 electrons. If it can get 4 electrons, of course, its octet become complete, right? So either it can lose its 4 electrons or it can gain 4 electrons. And both these two processes are not easy to carry out. You cannot take all the 4 electrons from the carbon. And same time, you cannot add all the 4 electrons, because carbon do not have enough energy and enough attraction power so that it can attract electrons. So in that situation, carbon in fact follow the sharing mode of bonding, right? So it can share 4 electrons with other atom to attain stability, resulting in the formation of covalent bond. And here I have shown that carbon, around the carbon, there are 4 electrons represented as cross. And when it will share by 4 other elements, then of course it will form 4 bonds. And for formation of covalent, I have discussed it. That is the sharing of electron. Here in this case, hydrogen formation, you can study. There is 1 electron in each of the hydrogen atom. You can see the last part of the slide. That is, yes, here. You can see that one hydrogen atom has 1 electron. So both these two atoms are sharing their electron to form a bond, that is single bond. When the sharing of electron, there is only 2 electrons shared between the atom, then it will form single bond. And when they share the 2 electrons, they will form like this double bond. And when they share 3 electrons, they form triple bond. And that is, in fact, we discussed in last class as well. So I'm going through this concept rather quickly. And this is the pictorial representation by which you can say 1 electron of these 2 hydrogen atoms come to each other and shared between the 2 atoms. And here in case of fluorine, you can say, here in case of oxygen, you can say there are sharing of 2 electrons from each atom. And in case of carbon dioxide, you can say carbon shared 2 electrons to each of the oxygen atom. Carbon here sharing 2 electrons of each of the oxygen atom. Here you can say this is your 2 electron from carbon, that is represented by blue dot, and orange dot in fact represented for oxygen atom. So either side you can see there are two electron of carbon and oxygen shared between in the carbon molecule, I mean oxide, dioxide, and that is how you can represent carbon dioxide. Here you can say carbon and fluorine. Carbon have 4 electron in outer shell, you can see here, right? And they are represented as orange dot. But in case of fluorine, there are 7 electron in their outer shell. It require only 1 electron to complete its octet. So what it can do? There are 4 fluorine atom coming around the carbon, and they share their electron so that they can form carbon tetrachloride. Now we can represent electron dot structure what we are drawing for our compounds. For methane, you can see carbon share 4 electron each with hydrogen atom, and it will form CH4 molecule. That is, you can see here carbon to hydrogen and carbon to hydrogen as a single bond, right? Here you can see. So you can compare it. The 2 electrons which is shared between carbon and hydrogen can be represented at one line, that is single bond, right? So this is the your electron dot structure, and this is your bond representation. So we can represent the molecule either in this form, of course, and in the bond form. These all, in fact, I discussed in the previous class. Again, the most important point after discussing just introductory part of bonding nature in the carbon and other compounds and other elements, why carbon form large number of compounds? That is the pertinent question we have to answer every time. Carbon form very large number of compounds, you know. And here it is just mentioned that there are more than 3 million compounds of carbon itself. I have shown some of the you for your study, I mean understanding. In fact, the best point of the carbon is that it can form bond by sharing of electron to other carbon. That means carbon can bonded with other carbon, and they can bond together in any length. In any length. So this process is known as, and this property is known as catenation. Carbon atom can form bond with other carbon atom to form long chain, branch chain, and close chain, and this property is called catenation. And in the last class I discussed why and how catenation can be explained. The most important point I discussed that was the strength of carbon-carbon bond, right? Apart from tetravalency, that is one point. Apart from electronegativity, that you will see in next class. The most important thing is the strength of carbon-carbon bond. It is not too weak and not too strong, so that they can hold large number of atom. And you know the valency of carbon is 4. It can form bond with other 4 atoms. Here you can see in case of a long chain, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, like this, n number of carbons can combine in a straight chain in the linear fashion. This is known as chain for a long chain. But when you see that carbon is getting branched at some point of the carbon, that is from C1 to C2, then C2 to C3, then C3 to C4. Here in this case, I am observing, and you are seeing that at the second carbon, there is one branch, and the third carbon, it is another branch. So these are the branch chain. And the valency which is left, in fact, you can say another carbon can come and join to this. Any other element apart from the carbon can also join. But in case of closed chain, the one carbon started with bonding with other carbon, and they come finally to the final carbon, combines with or bonded with the first carbon. In that way, they form a loop or chain, right? This is the closed chain structure, right? Here you can say, suppose I am taking, this is the first carbon, then it is second carbon, third carbon, fourth carbon, fifth carbon, sixth carbon, and again go to the first carbon. So first and sixth carbon are bonded together. In that way, you can see they form a closed chain, right? And in the branch, you have already seen. Okay. Next point is the hydrocarbon. Friend, what is the hydrocarbon? name itself indicate that this is the compound of carbon and hydrogen. You can break down the hydrocarbon into two element, one is hydrogen, another is carbon. And hydrocarbon can be of two type, either saturated or unsaturated. So hydrocarbon you must understand at this level, this is the compound containing carbon and hydrogen, right? Saturated hydrocarbon are those hydrocarbons in which there are only single covalent bond, there are no double bond between the carbon atom. So when you see that the covalent bond, single covalent bond formed between the carbon atom, then they are the saturated hydrocarbon. Sorry. One of the example of saturated hydrocarbon is the alkane, and for alkane you can see the example of methane and ethane. Here in case of methane, the formula is CH4, and of course carbon is bonded with four different hydrogens, so all are the single bond. But in case of ethane, this is the two carbon compound, and the bond between carbon and carbon is the bond between carbon and carbon is the single bond. Now, unsaturated hydrocarbon, they are the hydrocarbon having double or triple bond between the two carbon atom. It must be there. When you find there is double bond or triple bond between the two carbon atom, then they are unsaturated. When there are single bond, then they are saturated. When there are double or triple bond, then they are unsaturated. And one of the example of the unsaturated hydrocarbon is alkene. Alkene, there is double bond between the two carbon atom, and in case of alkyne, there is a triple bond between the carbon atom, right? You can say here, in this case, there are double bond between carbon-carbon atom. And you can also count the bond between the carbon, that is two hydrogen and two double bond. So that total become four bond. And one of the compound, the first compound is the ethene, the second compound is propene, and this is the three carbon compound, and here you are observing that there is double bond between carbon and carbon. Similarly, you can take case of alkyne, where there are triple bond between carbon and carbon. This is ethyne, first compound of the alkyne, and the second compound of the compound, I mean alkyne, is propyne. You can see here propyne. In case of propyne, you can say there is a triple bond between the first and second carbon. Right, so saturated hydrocarbon and unsaturated hydrocarbon. Then next phenomenon which we have to discuss, and that is new today itself. This is the isomerism. Iso means identical. Mer matlab morphology. When something is same but something is different, I am just talking in the layman's word. Some property you will find identical, but some property will be different. So in the organic compound, this is very common phenomenon. This is isomerism. You will find there are lots of compound which have same molecular formula, but their structures are different. You will find there are lots of compound having the same molecular formula, but their structures are different. And those set of compound which have same molecular formula but different structures, they are the isomers. Here you can see the example of butane, right? Butane, the formula of butane is C4H10, and C4 you can say all the four carbon 1, 2, 3, 4, they are aligned in one straight chain, and that is known as normal butane, right? And next compound, that is isobutane, you can see there is only three carbon in the straight chain, and fourth one is the branched one. And from first to second, then third, at the second carbon, you can say there is one bond which is bonded with another carbon. So the formula of the compound is same. The formula of compound, this is the first carbon, this is the second. With the second, I can observe another carbon bonded here. and this is the third carbon. So here you can see there is only three carbon, here there is four carbon, but formula is same, C4H10, and these two compounds, one is butane, another is isobutane, and you will see the name of these compounds in other classes, right? So they are the isomer. In case of pentane, the formula is C5H12, and you can find there are three isomers. In the first, all the five carbons are in the same chain, I mean straight chain. In the isobutane, there is one branch, and in neopentane, you can say there is a two branch. There is a two branch here. In case of isopentane, this is first carbon, and at the second carbon, you can say there is a branch of another carbon chain, right? And in case of neopentane, you can say at the second carbon, this is the first carbon, this is the second carbon, this is third carbon. At the second carbon, you can see there are two branches, right? So friend, by this you can see, by following the same formula, we have different compounds, and such phenomenon is known as isomerism, right? Another thing is very important while we are studying the organic compound, that is the functional group. An atom or a group of atom which decide the property of carbon compound, they are called functional group. Let me take example by calling my own name. Myself is Atal Misra. In the my family, one thing is very common, that is Misra. Similarly, in the family of other persons, they have their title, name. First name will be different, but the title will be same. So you can say something characteristic property belong to that functional group, right? By saying Misra, there are lots of things coming to in your mind. What type of tradition I would follow, like this. Similarly, when something different other than the carbon, some different element other than carbon join with the family of carbon compound, then they alter the property. And of course, the apart from common property of carbon, you will find something characteristic properties owned by that compound. So such compound which show the characteristic property with the due to presence of different atom or group of atoms. These atoms or group of atoms are known as functional group. Like in case of halogens, chlorine, bromine, etc. You will see that in this case, this is chloromethane. This is chloromethane, friend. Why? Because you can see it is the derivative of methane. Methane is CH4. One of the hydrogen displaced by chlorine. Earlier it was methane, now it is chloromethane. So whenever one of the hydrogen, two of the hydrogen rather, for simplicity, we are just displacing only one hydrogen from the parent compound, that is either alkane or alkene or alkyne. But for your level of study, we are taking alkane. So in case of methane, you are replacing one of the hydrogen by chlorine. The name becomes chloromethane. Now they are different from methane. Earlier it was methane. Similarly, you can also displace one of the hydrogen of ethane by chlorine or bromine. Then it becomes bromoethane or chloroethane. Next functional group is the alcohol. Next functional group is the alcohol. Alcohol, in fact, represented by OH group. OH group, where you have replaced, where you have replaced chlorine, you can simply replace OH. And whenever you see the OH with the organic compound, their name terminated to ol. Like in this case, you see this is chloromethane. Now this is methanol. Methane plus ol, methanol. Whenever you see the OH group, then its name become ol, that is methanol. Similarly, you can say ethanol, right? Another functional group is aldehyde, that is a CHO group. You can replace this Cl by OH, then it become ol, that is methanol. Before that, it was methane. Now, at this point, it is chloromethane. Here, it become methanol. Now, when you replacing the chlorine by CHO group, then its name ended with al. Like in case of OH, it was ol. here you can see the name is al. So al, name end with al, like in this case of, this is the first compound of aldehyde, and this is of only one carbon atom, sorry, this is one carbon atom compound, and one carbon, for one carbon you are using only meth, so it is a methanol. In this case, next compound CH3CHO, that is ethanol. This is the ethanol, you can say, because this is the two carbon compound. Now another functional group is COOH. COOH, that is also represented by this C double bond O and C single bond OH, and you can replace CHO, like in this case C double bond O and H. You can say simply H replaced by OH here, and the name ended with oic acid. Like in the case of this compound, this is one carbon compound, so methanoic acid. Another is two carbon compound, ethanoic acid, right? And next compound is ketone. The functional group of ketone is C double bond O, right? And the name ended with on, and that is what you can say, if it is coming between, and it must come between the two carbon atom. So 1, 2, 3 carbon are there. This is the first carbon, this is the second carbon, this is third carbon. So the name becomes simply propanone. And here you can see there are 1, 2, 3, 4. And in C2 there are two carbon. So its name become butanone. Its name become butanone, right? In this way, by using functional group, the name of compound also changes. To study the name of organic compound, we have another section, that is the IUPAC nomenclature of the organic compound, that will I take in some moment of the our lecture. And next point is the homologous series. I discussed this series in last class in greater detail, but I am just reminding you what is the homologous series. Homologous series is a group of compounds having similar structure, similar chemical properties, and whose successive members are differ. The most important point, what you can see in case of homologous series, in case of homologous series, they have similar structure, similar chemical properties, and whose successive members differed by CH2 group. You can see all the compounds like alkane, alkene, alkyne, haloalkane, alcohol, then aldehyde, ketone, acid, ester, etc. You will see host of compounds present in case of organic group of compounds, which in fact we are discussing here. So every two members are successive members must be differed by CH2 group. For the example, we have taken here methane. Methane, for methane, it is one carbon compound, so the next carbon, that is two carbon compound, the name become ethane. For one carbon it is meth, for two carbon it is eth, for three carbon it is prop, for four carbon it is but, and for five carbon it is pent. You can just take the five carbon in your study right now. First carbon, again I am reminding you, for first carbon, the name is started with meth. So main, the basic word for first carbon, I mean one carbon is meth. Basic word for the, that is root word in fact. The basic word for the two carbon is eth. For three carbon, it is prop. For four carbon, it is but. For five carbon, it is pent. And you can see also, for six, it is hex. For seven, it is hept. For eight, it is oct. For nine, it is none. And for 10, it is dec. But that is not going to be very common for your current study, and in the 10th standard we have to just focus up to 5 carbon. So again I am reminding, whenever you have a compound with one carbon, you can start the name by writing using the term meth. Like methane, you can go to chloromethane, then next methanol by using OH group, then you can write methanoic acid, methanol, right? Methanol, HCHO, methanoic acid, HCOOH. Similarly, ethane, chloroethane, ethanol, ethanoic acid. Take the example, propane, chloropropane at the first carbon. When you are replacing the at the second carbon, then it becomes 2-chloropropane. Then similarly, you can go to propanol or propane 2-ol, Then propionic acid, and they are in the terminal position. Propionaldehyde, they are always at terminal. Butane, chlorobutane, 1-chlorobutane, 2-chlorobutane, because you can replace carbon at the first carbon and second carbon. And I will see all those things in the coming structure, which is in fact visible to your board. All right, butane, then chlorobutane, 1-chlorobutane, 2-chlorobutane. Similarly, you can go to butanol, butane-2-ol, butanoic acid, butanoic acid, and butanol. Similarly, you can write pentane, chloropentane, number one. Then at the second carbon, you can find 2-chloro, then 3-chloro. Similarly, pentanol, pentane-2-ol, pentane-3-ol, pentanoic acid, etc. These are the method by which we can replace one of the hydrogen atom by a group like chlorine. Atom or group like chlorine, OH, CHO group, COOH group. So their name and properties become quite different. Here you can see again, here in case of methane, I am just replacing one of the hydrogen and see it become different compounds. Similarly, here you can replace one of the hydrogen. In this case, this is the first carbon, second carbon, and third carbon. If you are replacing at the first carbon, then it become first chloro, that is 1-chloro. When you are replacing at the second carbon, then it become 2-chloro. Similarly, next compound of the series is alkene, homologous series. The next homologous series, I am taking alkene. And here you are, here we have the different example are on the screen. That is ethene, propene, butene, pentene. Again, I would like to remind you, for ethene, it is 2-carbon. For propene, it is 3-carbon. For butene, it is 4-carbon. For pentene, it is 5-carbon. Again, you can recall without viewing the slide. For 1-carbon, it 2. Sorry, first for 1-carbon, it is meth. For 2-carbon, eth and 3, prop, 4, but, 5, pent. In this way, you can recall the name at every step of your study. But the most important thing which we are discussing right now, between C2H4 and C2H6, what you can see? The difference between these two compounds is CH2, again CH2, again CH2. And that is what they constitute homologous series. Here you can replace one of the hydrogen by chlorine, by OH group, by CHO group, etc. And their name can be changed accordingly, right? That is how you can relate these compound with the name. Next is the alkyne. Alkyne, the general formula of alkyne is CnH2n-2. Alkyne, you can see the general formula of alkyne is CnH2n-2. And again, for alkyne, we are starting with the 2-carbon ethyne, then next is propyne, then next is butyne. All these things I discussed in the last class. So I am just moving quickly, and here you can say there is a triple bond. I think this is missing in our slide. Between these two carbon, there is triple bond. Similarly, you can always see there is triple bond, and these two compounds like first, second, and second, third, they are differ by CH2 group. The next important property of the carbon compound, the next important compound. Physical property we have discussed for carbon, you can see by observing coal, fuel, etc. You can mention their physical properties, some may be liquid, some may be solid, some may be gas. But many a time you can see how the chemical properties help you to determine the nature of organic compound. How the chemical compounds are helping you to determine the nature of organic compound. Here we are taking the sum of example, and I will show the demo for that. The first chemical property of carbon compound is the combustion. The first chemical property of the organic compound of carbon is the combustion. When the carbon burns in oxygen, it will form carbon dioxide. Same time, heat and light will also evolve. The first compound of carbon is the methane, and when you burn methane in oxygen, you will see formation of carbon dioxide and water, same time heat and light will also evolve. Ethanol, that is your another organic compound used in sanitizer and of course in alcoholic product which people are using for their enjoyment and joy. Also when it burns in oxygen, you will see there is the formation of CO2 and heat and light. I am just showing the burning of your Deepak in your household. Yes, I will see. Okay, I think it is visible to you. This is the what? You can say this is one of the great ritual in our family and our house. This is what? Diya. And I have taken the ghee, or you can also use oil. This is what? This is the combustion. You can see if there is a lower amount of oxygen, then lots of fume will coming out from the here. And where we are burning this lamp, I mean diya, you will see lots of black precipitate observed inside the and around the place where we are putting all these things. This is what combustion. And in this combustion, what is happening? The oil or ghee that I have taken into this pot, right? It is burned in presence of oxygen and they are producing carbon dioxide. And the proof of carbon dioxide there is that if you keep your hand over the this lamp for the some moment, you will see there is the appearance of dark spot, right? And due to dust, they are precipitated in the form of dust, rather you can say smoke and this. And heat is also coming. I cannot put my hand over this for longer period of time. And of course, you are seeing the light. In case of candle, you can also see, right? And another example is the oxidation. Another example is the oxidation. Yeah, oxidation is looking like the combustion. In case of combustion, our compound burns in oxygen. When oxygen added to the organic compound in some number, that is either in full or in parts, then of course you can say our compound, one of the compound changes into other compound. Let me take one of the example. Organic compound like alcohol, when treated with a reagent alkaline KMnO4, and you will see that reagent in laboratory, since we are in my home, I mean our home, that reagent cannot I procure for you. Acidify chromate, either acidify chromate or alkaline KMnO4, when you put some drop of these two material, one of the two material, either first one or second one, when you are putting that material into ethanol and heat, you will see the formation of ethanoic acid. Ethanol changes to ethanoic acid. What change you can see? In fact, if you open the structure of ethanol, you can write this C2H5 as CH3CH2 and then OH. And CH3 remain here as such without any change. But in case of CH2, that changes into COOH. And you know this is the ethanol because of two carbon compound. Again here the two carbon are intact and the name become ethanoic acid. So when alcohols are treated with some reagent, a specified reagent which supplied a calculated amount of oxygen to the compound, they convert them into the next compound, that is different compound. And one of the example I shown here, that is conversion of ethanol to ethanoic acid. Friend, next example I am taking. This is what? Addition reaction. Addition reaction is what? That means you are going to add something to given compound. Addition means I am adding something. You know the simple meaning of addition, I am sure. In the case of saturated hydrocarbon, all the bond of carbon is satisfied, because carbon have tendency to form four bond, and in the saturated hydrocarbon all the four bonds are satisfied. But in case of unsaturated hydrocarbon, like in case of alkene or alkyne, there is a double bond between two of the carbon. In fact, given chance, carbon have tendency to break one of the bond of two bond, that is double bond, to convert it into saturated hydrocarbon. Right? Again, carbon have tendency to convert its double bond into single bond. And how they can convert? By breaking the double bond. And when this become double, one of the double bond broken between carbon and carbon, so the residual bond of each carbon must be combined with some other element so that they can satisfy all the four valency. This is the what addition reaction is. In fact, you can see here C2H4 plus H2. You can see C2H4. That means we are adding one of the hydrogen atom molecule here in the ethene, which converted it into ethane, right? Here, one of the hydrogen molecule added to ethene and it converted into ethane. But these two, which is written over this arrow, that is nickel or palladium. Nickel or palladium, they are the catalyst. They are helping to ethene. They are helper for ethene and bringing hydrogen from surrounding area, and they are adding to the hydrogen across the double bond. Here you can, haan sir.
Sir, screen ke upar ek chota screen jo hai usko hata band kar dijiye.
Chota screen aap hi ka dikh raha hai sir. Isko hata do.
Haan, usko band kijiye.
Okay. And theek hai sir.
You want to go for the break, sir?
I can. So thoda sa pyaas bhi lag rahi hai na, garmi hai aaj.
Okay. So, dear learner, we will go for a break of 5 minutes and then we will resume it.
Hello, sir. इसको हर्षल को बुलाओ, कट तो नहीं करना ना इसको,
इसको
कनेक्ट तो होगा ना, फिर कनेक्ट रहेगा,
देख लूंगा।
ऐसे दिखाने से समझ में आ जाएगा फोटो। यहाँ पे रख के तो बोर्ड पढ़ा सकता हूँ थोड़ी देर के लिए, नॉमिन क्लेचर थोड़ा पढ़ा देता हूँ।
तो रखेंगे
इसी के ऊपर रख दे,
रख लीजिए इतना बजे
तो पैंट पहन पाए तो अगर आ जाते हैं तो। नहीं हटा दो थोड़े देर, उसको गेट बंद कर दो,
ईयरफोन हटा दो।
हाँ तुम देखो बता देना, इस पे चमक रहा हो तो इसको बुझा देना। वो खुद ही अगर कट कर दिए होंगे तो आ जाएंगे। और ऊपर करना मुझे लगता है वो छोटी टेबल्स के ऊपर रखता हूँ।
अभी स्क्रीन शेयर नहीं करनी है ना,
थोड़ा दिन के लिए
स्टॉप शेयरिंग कर दूँ?
नहीं नहीं स्टॉप नहीं करूँ, चलो हाँ
फिर स्टार्ट कर दूँगा ना।
पर हम लोग को तो अपना स्क्रीन दिखता नहीं है।
नहीं
कहाँ दिख रहा है,
नीचे का तो इसका हेड को पूरा दिखाई नहीं दे रहा हो सकता।
कहाँ तक दिख रहा था इसमें, यहाँ तक तो वही टेबल उठा कर
बैठेगा कैसे इसका?
अरे इसका आपको थोड़ा तो चढ़ जाएगा,
बहुत नहीं चढ़ और बैठेगा ही नहीं, इस पर फिसल जाएगा। छोड़ दीजिए इतना ठीक है, हल्का सा इतनी हाइट पर पता है आप, मैं बता दूंगा कितने पर खींचना है। बड़ा
रेडी है सर?
रेडी है सर?
हाँ सर रेडी हूँ। ओके सर,
एक मिनट,
एक मिनट
सर। स्क्रीन पे बोर्ड दिख रहा है क्या थोड़ा सा?
हाँ हाँ दिख रहा है,
दिख रहा है।
जितना और नीचे जा सकता हूँ कि बस उतने लिखूँ जहाँ तक लिखा है?
नहीं थोड़ा सा, थोड़ा सा, थोड़ा सा और ऊपर कर सकते हैं उसको चाहिए तो। बोर्ड को सीधा कर लीजिए।
ऐसे ऐसे
नहीं, ऐसे हाँ हाँ ऐसे, हाँ ऐसे सीधा कर लीजिए।
अच्छा बेटा उसको नीचे रखते हैं सर, एक मिनट होल्ड करिएगा।
हाँ हाँ
ये कॉपी रखते हैं, इसके ऊपर होता है ना ऐसे ऐसे। हाँ अब बताओ सर।
हाँ आप ना, नहीं ये जो है ना आपका जहाँ पे वो पेट है उसके ऊपर होना चाहिए लिखने का। नीचे से आप जितना ऊपर कर सकते हैं, ऊपर आपका बुक्स तक जा सकते हैं और हैंडल तक जा सकते हैं। यस हाँ
यहाँ तक,
हाँ वहाँ तक आप जा सकते हैं सर।
अच्छा,
क्योंकि नीचे से कटता है।
मैं समझ गया सर, समझ गया। लेकिन इसको रखने कोई इंतजाम खास है नहीं मेरे पास, वो तो छोटा इसको पटक यार सर। एक मिनट देखो वो वाला बोल रहा
हूँ,
ये बुक्स ही दे दो काम चल जाएगा सर। और अब ठीक है सर?
हाँ हाँ ये बढ़िया है,
विजिबिलिटी भी ठीक है।
हाँ ठीक है,
हाँ थोड़ा सा चीजें बता दूंगा बच्चों को ना, फिर वापस आ जाएंगे स्क्रीन पर हम लोग।
ठीक है ठीक है, वेट कीजिए। हाँ हाँ लाइव दे दीजिए। गो लाइव सर।
ओके सर, थैंक यू फ्रेंड्स। बिफोर गोइंग टू ब्रेक वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द आईयूपीएसी नेम ऑफ ऑर्गेनिक कंपाउंड। सिंस दिस इज वेरी लार्ज टॉपिक विच वी हैव टू डिस्कस इन, अगेन आई एम सेइंग इन द हायर क्लासेस, बट एट दिस लेवल ऑफ योर स्टडी दैट इज इन द 10th क्लास, यू कैन यूज सम ऑफ द बेसिक कॉन्सेप्ट फॉर नॉमेनक्लेचर फॉर ऑर्गेनिक कंपाउंड। आई वॉज रिपीटिंग द these terms continuously for you. For C1 this is meth, for C2 it is eth, for C3 it is prop, for C4 it is but, and for 5 it is pent, 6 for hex, etc. Let me take one by one, and you have to become very familiar, and you will become familiar with the nomenclature in the coming 4 to 5-7 minutes. Please be hold. If I am discussing alkane, you have to just take this word, that is in, and I am writing CH4, that is one carbon. So elk I will replace as meth and the name become methane. See, this is the one carbon, and for one carbon you know the term we are using meth, right? And here you have to just replace elk by the term meth, and the name comes to you methane. You can try next compound C2S6 and eth in, that is ethane, C3H8, come on, I think you may write propane, C4H10, butane, right? C5H12, that is pentane. And how I am writing all these formula quickly? Because the general formula of alkane, you know, CnH2n+2, that I have discussed. I have discussed these things in the last class. And for here I am taking 1, so 1 into 2, that is 2 plus 2 become 4. So methane, ethane, propane, butane, and they all are the compounds of homologous series. You can see they are differ by CH2 group, right? Similarly, I am going to demonstrate the next class of compound, that is alkene. This is the important term, in, and alk is there. For two carbon, you know, for two carbon the basic term is eth, so I am taking that term and writing it for you, ethene. For 3 carbon, you can write as prop and then ene. And friend, it is CN and H2N. This is the basic formula of compound. Similarly, you can go to butene and all. Again, you can discuss alkyne. The formula of alkyne, CN, H2N minus 2. Okay, friend? And I am writing C2H2. 2 2s are 4, minus 2 become 2. And the name become ethyne. C3H3, 2 6 minus 2, that is 4. C3H4, that is propyne. Similarly, you can cruise up to butyne, pentyne, etc. Let me take another class of the example, that is halo group. When one of the halogen, I mean hydrogen of methane replaced by halogen group like chloro, like bromo, then its name written as, first you just write haloalkane, and this alkane is methane. So what is the halomethane? I mean, what is the halo here? This is chloro. So name become chloromethane, bromomethane. C2H6 is the compound of alkane, that is ethane. I am just replacing one of the hydrogen by chloro group. Then I can call it chloroethane. And you can see this is the CH3, CH2, CH3. This is propane. I can replace either this carbon or this carbon. CH2Cl, CH2, CH3. This is your chloropropane. This is your chloropropane at the first carbon. When you are replacing the one of the carbon at this level, then it becomes 2-chloropropane. 2-chloropropane. That all are the study of higher classes, but I am just taking some simple example to make it clear so that you can write the name of organic compound. Friends, similarly, if I am replacing one of the hydrogen by OH group, then meth is going to stay here. This time methane and plus all, methanol, CH3, CH2, OH, then it become ethanol. Next, propanol, CH3, CH2, CH2, OH, propanol. I can also write here CH3 and this time OH is here. So you can write this name, I mean propane to all. This is at second carbon. And here you can see these two compounds are different. At the first carbon, propanol. At the second carbon, propane to all. But their formula is same. Their structures are something different. They have something different properties. And that's how they are related to each other. And you know the phenomenon is isomerism. The phenomenon is isomerism. This is the, how you can write the name of the compounds of alcohol family. Similarly, I am just taking the one of the most important compound of this organic compound, that is acid. And here I am just writing term OEC acid. So if you are taking only one carbon, then you have to write methanoic acid. When you are increasing the carbon by one number, then it becomes ethanoic acid. Ethanoic acid. Similarly, you can go to propanoic acid, butanoic acid, and if you are adding next group, that is aldehyde, for that you have to use term al, HCHO. This is one carbon. So I can write methanol. If I am taking one more carbon, CH3CHO, then I can write is ethanol. Similarly, one more group in fact mentioned in your a book that is ketone. Here for the ketone, you can see there is a carbon oxygen double bond and the two of the valency of carbon remain vacant. And this is your ketone. And you have to add alkane plus one. That means you have to add alkanone. See, I am taking CH3, CO, CH3, 1, 2, 3. This is the 3 carbon. For 3, you know, this is a propane. So the name become propanone. So at the, by studying all these things, by taking all these examples, you can just try to practicize the name of organic compound by taking the number of carbon into consideration. Like for first, I mean, 1 carbon, this is your C1, methane, then ethane, propane, butane. And just replacing N by ON by all by oic acid, you can get the name of different compounds. Different compounds. And let me resume our previous session, which we have discussing with you. Yes. Thank you very much. Okay, friend. One of the reaction before going to break, I was discussing about the addition reaction. And in addition reaction, it simply says that you are adding something. And in case of ethene, I am adding hydrogen with the help of catalyst, nickel or palladium. And here you can say this is the formation of saturated hydrocarbon from unsaturated compound. So addition reaction basically used for the conversion of your unsaturated hydrocarbon into saturated hydrocarbon. This is the most important. And one of the common application of the, this addition reaction is the conversion of oil into ghee. That is oil like coconut oil and etc. palm oil. You can convert it into vanaspati ghee. And this process is known as hydrogenation because you are adding hydrogen here. Next reaction is substitution. Next reaction is the substitution. Substitution itself indicate that what is the meaning of the reaction. In the cricket match or football match, if one of the player got injured, you have seen that one of the player which is sitting outside the ground coming and replacing that player who is suffering some problem during the play. And that player is basically always known as substituent, right? Similarly, whenever we are replacing any of the atom or group of atoms by some other atom or group of atoms, then we will get something new compound. Like I earlier discussed, in case of methane, when you are replacing one of the hydrogen by chlorine, then you are getting chloromethane. Like in case of methane, when you are replacing one of the hydrogen by chlorine, then you are getting chloromethane. Similarly, when you are replacing chlorine by OH group, then you are getting alcoholic group. When you are replacing the OH group by COH group, then you are getting either aldehyde or acid or ketone, etc. But that is not directly carrying out. I am just cutting one of the element and getting adding one of the atom or group of atom. So substitution reaction in hydrocarbons, you see that is halogenation. When you are replacing with halogen, then it is halogenation. And one of the example quoted here for you, that is when you are treating methane with chlorine, you are getting CH3 plus HCl. That means one of the chlorine goes to methane and one of the chlorine goes to with the hydrogen. And when you are replacing this chloromethane with another, then you are getting another substituted product, and one by one you can take out the hydrogen to convert chloromethane, dichloromethane, trichloromethane, and then tetrachloromethane. Trichloromethane, that is CHCl3, also known as chloroform. And earlier it was used as anesthesia. Now some of the important compound we have to study in the 10th class, that is one of the important compound is ethanol, and I have shown you sanitizer in the early beginning of the lecture. Sanitizer, you know, now it is buzzword. You have to sanitize your hand after regular interval of time to protect yourself from the infection of coronavirus, right? In fact, sanitizer basically contains ethanol, that is ethyl alcohol. And you know ethanol, how you can prepare, you know. We can prepare it by replacing one of the hydrogen of ethane by chlorine and subsequently by OH group. Then we will get ethanol. Otherwise, in industry and other world, industrial level, you can prepare ethanol by different method. That is not the study of today itself. But as a student of 10th, you must be aware of the ethanol. Ethanol is a colorless liquid. Colorless liquid, in fact, just like water. And its smell is pleasant, but its taste is burning. So those who are consuming alcohol, in fact, they have that taste. Alcohol is soluble in water, that is very much clear. You have seen that people are taking some part of alcohol and added into water to make their peene wala. Next, ethanol, when treated with sodium metal, you know the sodium metal is a highly reactive metal. In fact, it takes out hydrogen from the any compounds which have replaceable hydrogen, like in case of water, in case of ethane, sodium have that tendency, that reactivity, that it can take out the hydrogen. Here you can also see in case of ethanol, when it is treated with sodium, in place of sodium, hydrogen coming out from the ethanol and your compound converted into sodium ethoxide. Similarly, when ethanol is reacted with hot concentrated H2SO4, hot concentrated H2SO4 is the dehydrating agent. When you add some drop of H2SO4 to water and simply heat it, you will find that water removed from the alcohol and the C2H5, here you can see C2H5, one of the OH and one of the H is coming out from the molecule. It will remain only C2H4. That reactions are known as dehydration reaction, and water will eliminated here. And you know, ethanol. What is the use of ethanol? People are using for drinks. Ethanol is also used as solvent, and it is also used for making medicine like tincture of iodine, cough syrup, tonics, and in every household you can find the cough syrup and all. Those people who are suffering from the throat infection and all. Next important compound is ethanoic acid. Also known as acetic acid, also known as vinegar. And I, again, in the beginning of this lecture, I shown acetic acid from my house itself. It is prepared from my own sugar cane, and in what are the properties of acetic acid? It is again colorless liquid. Since what I have shown you, it is crude one. It is called vinegar. So vinegar is a small amount of 5 ml in 95 ml of water, or 8 ml in 92 ml of water. That total becomes 100. one of the reaction that is esterification. That is very important. You have to learn it, and a very very common question when you will deal with your problems. I mean, go through the question during the examination. When ethanoic acid treated with ethanol, it will form ester, which have fruity smell. When you treat alcohol and acid, that is ethanoic acid, together with little pinch of concentrated H2SO4, when you heat it gently, you will see that a smell just like fruit smell coming out from the mixture, and where you can see that some fruit is in fact ripening around the your reaction mixture. That is why in fact it is also known as fruity smell. And the reaction during in the reaction you will see the formation of ester, and that's why the reaction is known as esterification. In fact, I am going to show this reaction for you, and you can feel it. I'm sure you are not going to impact small. Drop of centyl, and this is your vinegar. I'm adding together just by simply shaking, since it is very hard material. I think it is very concentrated one. Just shake it and smell it. You will see that very good fruity smell coming out of that. Might be it since acetic acid which I have taken here for your experiment, it is very hard. So majority of smell is belonging to this acid, that is vinegar. But when you perform this experiment in lab, in fact even from this distance you will find that fruity smell is coming out to you, and your friend will say that you have prepared some mango for your friend, right? This is what. So here one thing you must know, why the fruits have a smell. Why the fruits have a special smell? In fact, when you have taken the fruit, the raw fruits, in case of raw fruit, you have seen that there are acid. Like in a raw mango, it is sour in taste. And of course, there are variety of fruits belonging to citrus family. In the nascent stage, you can see that they are very sour to taste, but as they ripen, they become very tasty. Why? Where all the acid goes? You just focus on only one example, that is mango. The raw mango is very sour in taste. You cannot bite mango just like a ripened one, right? So what you have to do? We have to wait during the development of the fruit of mango. There are lots of chemical changes taking place inside the fruit itself, and all those acids which are present in the earlier part of the fruit formation, they converted into ester, and as acid converted to esters. As acid converted into esters, you can see the fruit become very tasty and with a specific smell. That is known as esterification. So what change you can see? From raw fruit to ripened, there is a change of acid to ester. That means esterification takes place. Now another example that is very important is the saponification. When ester is treated with sodium hydroxide, sorry that I do not have sodium hydroxide in my house right now, but ester I prepared for you. If you add just sodium hydroxide solution, you will find the sodium salt of carboxylic acid and the present alcohol. That means, well, with the alcohol which I added to the mixture, it will regenerate it. So what I in fact prepared this ester for you, I can take back alcohol from ester. How? If I am adding sodium hydroxide to the solution. When I am adding sodium hydroxide to the solution, alcohol will coming back, but my acid will change into, it will change into sodium salt, that is sodium acetate or potassium acetate. Now, I have discussed you that many of the ripened fruits contain esters. So, esters are present in many of the plant product, and we can also prepare ester by treating it with the alcohol. So, by using ester, I can prepare variety of sodium salt of the esters. When you are increasing the number of carbon, right from 2, 3, 4, 5, up to 15, 16, laureate, sodium palmate, all these are the terms, then you will find that these salts are appear as the precipitate, which in fact are converted in the form of cake, which I shown you, that is the soap and detergent. So, by saponification reaction, we can prepare soap and detergents. That is widely used in our household, and in today's world, that become very important, you know. Ethanoic acid as acid, you know, it is acid. So, it have very right to react with the base. So, if you have acid, then you can react it with the base like sodium hydroxide, and you will find the sodium acetate as the compound and loss of water, because during the neutralization, water is one of the product. Ethanoic acid also react with the carbonate and hydrogen carbonate to form salt and water. Carbonate, sodium carbonate and sodium bicarbonate. Use the washing soda and baking soda. Acetic acid is there in your house. Just add sodium carbonate and sodium bicarbonate, that is baking soda. Heat it gently, you will see there is evolution of gas. And of course, if your acetic acid is something other acid, you can prepare soap in your house itself. And in earlier days, when we do not have large industry like Tata, Reliance, etc., then people are preparing the soap in their household itself by using washing soda and baking soda. Now, at the last part of our chapter, we are coming at the soap and detergent. I have discussed what is the soap. Soaps are long chain sodium or potassium salt of carboxylic acid like sodium stearate. There are 17 carbon you are seeing here. Earlier, you are just dealing with the 2 carbon, sodium acetate. Now, there are 17 carbon. So, as you are increasing the number of carbon, the precipitation of the salt coming in the form of salt cake. In fact, that salt cake appear converted into either detergent powder or in the form of cake. And how the structures of soap molecule appears. In case of this arrow, which in fact this zigzag, the arrangement of the tail, in fact we are saying it is a tail of this whole structure. In fact, it is made up of hydrocarbon. Hydrocarbon means carbon and hydrogen. This 17 and S35. These are the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And like this, you can see there are 17 carbon. And the sodium part, that means this part, COONA part is here. This is your negative part, sodium bear positive charge. So this is your ionic part. This is non-ionic part, this is ionic part. In fact, you know, you cannot dissolve hydrocarbon in water. That is very much clear. You cannot dissolve kerosene, diesel, petrol, etc. in water. So the hydrocarbon part, this hydrocarbon part is do not dissolve in water, never dissolve in water. And this ionic part, they are basically dissolved in water. So whenever you dissolve soap into water, so you can see the whole molecule appears like this. Whole molecules appear like this, and they come. See, this is the head and this is the tail. This is the head and this is the tail. Here this is the tail. Head have negative charge. So all the negative charge in fact aggregate together to form micelles. And micelles are basically responsible for the cleansing action of soap. I have already this soap molecule have two part, long hydrocarbon part, which is hydrophobic, and short hydrophilic part, that is water attracting. And how the soaps are working? When the soap dissolve in water, it form a spherical structure called micelles. In each micelle, the soap molecules are arranged readily such that the hydrocarbon part is towards the center and the ionic part towards the outside. So all hydrocarbon part coming to the center, like in this case, here you can say all the tails are coming to the center and the negative charge coming outside the center, right? So hydrocarbon part dissolve the dirt. What is the dirt? When you are wearing your shirt and cloth, there are natural wax coming from your head part, that is from ear and around the head, and they all are deposited on your collar or wristband. I mean, thus wrist portion of your shirt. So as these wax are attached with your cloth, so the dirt particle already simply just come and absorb in. Like you are exposing your butter or oil, and after some time you then see that lots of dust coming to them and just precipitated over there. Now, like dissolve like, the grease part of our body is basically hydrocarbon, which is not dissolving in water. Otherwise, we can cleanse our cloth by simply rinsing with water. So the wax part of the your cloth dissolve in this hydrocarbon part, and when you just rotate the cloth in washing machine or just by beating them, all these parts coming away from the water, I mean cloth, they are just trapping the dirt molecule are coming out from the cloth. That is how you can see the cleansing action of the soap can. The hydrocarbon part dissolve the dirt, oil and grease and form an emulsion at the center of micelles, which can be washed away by water. So you see, that is very interesting property. In your cloth, there are lots of enemy coming from your surrounding, dirt, oil, and grease, etc. When you are dissolving the cloth into the soap solution, you will see that all these soap molecules come together as a party and trap these material and take away from the water. That is how you can say the cleansing action of the soap, right? I have already discussed it. Detergents and soap, they are the very important, and in fact, that is very good question for you. How the detergents are different from the chain, soap. Soap are the sodium salt of fatty acid, whereas detergent are the sodium salt of sulfonic acid. That is, you can say some kind of organic, inorganic compound. Soap clean well in soft water, but do not clean well in the hard water. And you know the water are two type. One is hard water that contain calcium and magnesium sulfate and the chloride. And detergents can clean in the both compound, both soft and hard water. So detergent are better in that way. Soap do not clean as well as detergent, means detergents can clean better than soap. We have detergent powder in our house. That is why we are using detergent powder, because they are better in action than the soap. Soaps are biodegradable and do not cause pollution. That is the one of the important point related with the soap. And detergents are non-biodegradable, and in every part of the country, like in river of Yamuna and Delhi and different city from which you are belonging, the water body have lots of foam and froth due to deposition of large amount of detergent, because detergents are used in different part of our life, like from household to industry and all. So that is how you can see. There are some advantages as well as some disadvantages. Before concluding the session, I can see, where is that part? Yeah. Revision. I am just going to revise all the concept which I have covered for you till now. So you can, before next slide coming to on your way, you just listen what I have discussed. The organic compound, the compounds of carbon. This is what, in fact, mind map, very important one. Carbon and its compound, you can say, we have studied the allotrope of carbon, which are three type: diamond, graphite, and fullerenes. And organic compounds are the compounds of carbon, you know. And when the carbon form compound with hydrogen, they form hydrocarbons. And hydrocarbons are of two type: that is saturated hydrocarbon and unsaturated hydrocarbons, right? And you studied very extensively about the bonding behavior of carbon, and the bonding behavior of carbon is the covalent bond. And covalency, you know, the number of electrons shared by atom. And here, in case of carbon, it is tetravalency because it shares the four electrons, right? And alkene or alkyne, they have different names. We have discussed it. When one of the hydrogen of alkene replaced by atom or group of atom, then they become functional group. And like alcohol, acid, then haloalkane, etc. And we discussed about homologous series, where the two successive compounds are differed by CH2 group. And alkene, alkyne, you discuss is catenation. We discuss about the catenation property. Friend, catenation is the self-linking tendency of element of carbon. And chemical property, I discuss about with you, that is combustion, oxidation, addition, and substitution, right? And you can draw the structures which we have discussed either in the form of electron dot structure or in the form of bond line notation. And two compounds I discussed, that is ethanol and ethanoic acid. And with ethanoic acid and ester, you can see we can prepare soap and detergent. Soap, in fact, prepared by the ethanoic acid, and ester and detergents are something inorganic compound, but you can use soap and detergent simultaneously. Both have some advantages and disadvantages. And the most important thing of the carbon and is that is of great importance. Carbon compounds are basically very good fuels, like in case of methane. You can see in case of methane, that is used as CNG and coal, etc. Right? Last point of this discussion, I am just taking you for some questions which I am just taking in front of you. Here some objective question and some subjective question, right? Okay, here you can see that 2, 3, 4, 6, 7 questions I have taken for you. Choose the correct general formula of alkane, and I am sure that you are going to detect it very easily. For alkane, it is CnH2n+2. If you can choose other options like CnH2n-2, then it is alkyne. And CnH2n, then it is the formula of alkene. According to given figure, how many electrons are shared by the oxygen? And shared electrons is in fact coming the overlapping zone of the between the two atom. And here in the overlapping zone, I can say there are four electrons shared. The nomenclature of alkene family are represented by general formula CnH2n. Now the answer following question: what is the name of alkene where n is 4? Of course, for 4, this is butene. Either at the first carbon or at the second carbon, then you can say but1-ene, but2-ene. Otherwise, butene is the correct answer. What is the molecular formula of alkene where N is 6? So N is 6, C6 and 6, 2 are 12. Then it becomes H6-12. So C6H12. What is the molecular formula and structural formula of the first member of alkene family? And well documented and well discussed right now. That is ethene, and you can write the formula of ethene, C2H4. Among the following, C2H6, C2H5, OH, CH3COOH, which is a hydrocarbon, and you can recognize the first one is hydrocarbon, second one is alcohol, and third one is the acid. Now you have to differentiate between saturated and unsaturated hydrocarbon. That is very much clear. Saturated have all the single bond, unsaturated have either double bond or triple bond, and you have to quote the example. The last question: what is the role of metal or reagent written on the arrow of the given chemicals? Here, nickel. In this reaction, nickel is the act as catalyst. In the second example, what you are taking, acid and alcohol are reacting together. So concentrated H2SO4 act as a catalyst where the esterification can take place. And in the last case, that is in case of ethanol, when treated with alkaline KMnO4, it converted into acid, and that is what? Oxidizing agent. And that's all about this chapter, and this is from my side. Thank you very much.